हाय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डीपी वाजपेयी। आई हैव बीन टीचिंग एस्पायरेंट्स ऑफ सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन फॉर द लास्ट 17 इयर्स। इन टुडेज टॉक आई एम गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन रोल ऑफ ऑप्शनल्स इन सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन आफ्टर 2013 वाज द सिलेबस ऑफ सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन वाज रिवाइज्ड, देन रोल ऑफ ऑप्शनल्स have become very very important and crucial. Before 2013, optionals used to occupy more than 66% weightage in the civil services examination. Now that weight has been reduced to about 40%, but still out of 1750 marks of civil services examination, optionals play a very crucial role, because in these subjects, optionals are the subjects which one has a choice. You can opt for any subject. You may be an engineering graduate and opt for physics, or you may be an engineering graduate of computer science, you may opt for history. That kind of cross academic background choice is available. Here I am going to tell you certain points about civil nature of civil services examination. It can be passed by any optional. Having said that this examination can be passed by any subject, then definitely counter question is that this examination can be very well passed with any science or engineering subject also. I am going to focus today particularly in my talk role of science optionals, because there is a rampant campaign that science optionals are not rewarding in this examination. With science optionals, people are not able to pass civil services examination. As far as our data is concerned, our information is concerned, every year with science optionals, like first of all, science optionals are the subjects which are not opted for any person without having a background. If you are opting for any science subject, physics or chemistry or mathematics, then definitely either you are a graduate or postgraduate in that subject, or you are an engineering graduate. You are familiar with the contours, broad contours of the subject. And here, one thing I can mention in the beginning itself, that the level of these questions is nothing to do with engineering entrance examination. Many of our science and science graduates and postgraduates are frightened that engineering, that the level of questions must be our IIT entrance and we have to face a competition with the IITs. Dear friends, this examination is of BSc and MSc level questions. The questions which are asked in the examination, they are typically the questions asked in Indian universities. And this examination is to provide you a level playing field. It is not to discourage you. This is nothing, no way that here optionals have been provided that the person with the physics background should not opt for him, for it, them. Or person with a chemistry background should not be able to opt for them. These subjects have been provided that the person who are a certain moderately level of intelligent person who have done their hard work in their BSc and MSc degree, BSc or MSc degrees, they should be able to do well. And definitely, I can ask a counter question. If you are a MSc in chemistry or MSc in physics and not opting for physics or chemistry, or you are MSc in mathematics and not opting for mathematics, then you are deprived of the whole knowledge. Your whole background goes waste if you are not opting that subject in the civil services examination. So first of all, this examination is nothing to do with engineering entrance kind of examinations. This examination is just typically your university kind of exams, but the kind of questions which are asked in this exam, although their level is university exam, but their evaluation is going beyond the books. They are testing your analytical skills. They are testing how to present the answers in a very coherent manner and your understanding of the course. If you understand any concept, you can write in proper words. Definitely, even if I am asking a derivation, then here my focus is not on the mathematical steps. Definitely, mathematical steps I am asking in the exam. But more important than mathematical steps is the physics behind the question or chemistry behind the question. Most often, we do not write down the physics part or chemistry part, and we straight away start writing down the derivation. That is what is the mistake common people make. So if you do not do those kind of mistakes, you are well familiar with the process of this examination. Science optionals are good, very good subjects, and they help you in many ways. Like, one, first of all, their syllabus is static. their syllabus being static, they can be easily prepared. And this subjects are language neutral. If even if your language, you do not have much command over the language, you do not have very flowery language, then also you can do well in with these subjects. Thank you.